Once again, back inside beautiful Bankers Life Fieldhouse in downtown Indianapolis. One classic game in the books and hopefully three more to go. It's time for the 2A state championship game between Westview and Park Tudor, a pair of programs that have multiple basketball state championships in their history. Again, alongside Bob Lovell, Chris May along for the ride as well. Greg Rakestraw with you. And Bob, in this game, we have a couple of different stories here. We've got a Park Tudor team that, frankly, everyone expected to be here. Westview was not the team that most thought would be representing the North. A couple of contrasting styles as well.
Well, I think you'll see contrasting styles in terms of obviously how they play. This is a Park Tudor team that likes to get up and down. They like to force the tempo. Westview is a half-court execution team. They're kind of a grind-it-out team. Have great scores, great players, and one thing they do, they play well together, a high IQ basketball team. So the contrast is clearly going to be a big factor in today's game, Greg.
It is easy to determine who the key player is for this Park Tudor ball club. He is easily one of the best players in the state, Trevon Bluiett. We'll focus on him in a matter of moments. Let's show you how this Park Tudor team got here, though. Their tournament trail, and really untested until the Clarksville game, that was a matchup of one versus two, and it played out like the two top teams in the state battling out for a right to go to Bankers Life Fieldhouse.
And tempo was big in that ball game, as I think it will be in this matchup. But you know, Park Tudor, obviously, to get here has played different styles and different tempos, and I think they feel comfortable either way.
Trevon Bluiett knows this stage very well for Park Tudor, aiming for a third state championship in four seasons, averaging, that's not a typo, folks, nearly 36 points a game. He'll play for Xavier next season.
It isn't a typo, and the hard thing to believe, too, is the game just comes to him. He doesn't force things. You're going to see him get the ball off the defensive rebound and take it coast to coast and make decisions. And he's going to see him score inside and out. You're going to see him do some things that we're going to marvel at throughout the rest of the day.
Tournament trail for Westview to get to this point. Their roadblock was Hammond Bishop Knoll. That was the team a lot of folks thought would make it downstate to battle Park Tudor for a second time in the last four seasons. Overtime victory there, and then two other good teams that were knocked off, Winnemac and a very good Cass team. Again, it is a Westview team that has been deep into the tournament the last several years, either regional or semi-state level, but making their first appearance in a state championship game in some 14 years. They're kind of a two-pronged attack. Chandler Aspie, but the young man we're going to focus on is Jordan Bontrager.
Love him. He's a great point guard. This kid can literally do it all. 17 a game, shoots over 53%. Look at him. He rebounds. He handles it. He delivers it to his teammates. He is a tremendous basketball player, Greg. In the open court, you must find him. He's just a smart basketball player, has multiple skills and loves to play and can win, as obviously evidenced by the fact that he's got his team here in the championship game.
Still a few minutes away from tip-off here between Park Tudor and Westview, and let's welcome the third member of our broadcast crew. He is the director of the Indiana Basketball Hall of Fame. Here's Chris May.
Thank you very much, Greg. You've spoken quite a bit about Trevon Bluiett, but the numbers really are impressive. He enters this game as the sixth all-time leading scorer in Indiana high school basketball history, 2,530 points. Just listen to some of the names he's passed this season on his way to that spot. Oscar Robertson, George McGinnis, Steve Alford, Kyle Macy. Most recently, he's passed Alan Henderson and Billy Shepard. If you're curious, he's 65 points behind Rick Mount for fifth place in Indiana's all-time history. It sounds like a record that he couldn't possibly get today, but with Bluiett and the season he's having, nothing seems impossible.
When 40 is an average night for you, Chris, you're right. Anything is possible. And what's been impressive to see for Bluiett, first couple of years played off of a player like Yogi Farrell. He's been much more of a focal point of this team offensively the last couple of years, and he's become a better player these last two seasons.
Well, I think he's also benefited, too, from the growth and maturity. And Kyle Cox's approach with this team has been to extend the court more defensively. We know they can get out in transition, but they're also creating a lot more opportunities through their defensive work. And I think certainly Bluiett has been the recipient of that increased tempo.
Still a few minutes away from tip-off of this game. We'll have some keys to tonight's contest when we come back. 2A state championship game just moments away here on Fox Sports Indiana.
All right.
Westview working the Lady Gaga. I love it.
The 104th Annual IHSAA Boys Basketball State Finals are brought to you by the Indiana Pacers and Indiana Fever, presenting sponsor of the IHSAA State Basketball Tournament, an honor to support Indiana's game at all levels. And by the following: Methodist Sports Medicine, in collaboration with IU Health, official sports medicine provider to the IHSAA. By Subway, eat fresh. Wilson Sporting Goods, the official ball of the IHSAA. Farmers Insurance, we are insurance, we are farmers. The Indianapolis Colts, the IHSAA, is proud to be Colt Strong. Sharp Business Systems, saluting great athletes and even better students. Sport Graphics, turning our creativity and experience into your results. And by Fox Sports Indiana, home of the IHSAA Champions Network. Getting a kick out of hearing the band from Westview High School play Hail to the Victors. It was a good night for that song last night. They're hoping for that to be the case here this afternoon, as well as Westview and Park Tudor getting ready for this 2A state championship game. Greg Rakestraw, Bob Lovell, Chris May with you here on the IHSAA Champions Network. Our game's presented by the Indiana Pacers and the Indiana Fever. And now it is time for our keys to today's game, presented by Wilson Sporting Goods, the official ball of the IHSAA. We start with the visitors on the scoreboard in the Park Tudor Panthers.
Well, obviously, they want to pressure the ball. They're a little more full court. It allows them, obviously, to dictate tempo. And I think the best thing that Park Tudor does, Greg, offensively, is get in transition. And when you have Trevon Bluiett in the open court, he's virtually impossible to stop.
As the Westview Warriors take the floor for their final warm-ups before today's 2A championship game, let's focus on their keys.
Well, you're going to hear Trevon Bluiett's name mentioned, and obviously in transition, you must find him. You must get to him as fast as you can and not allow him to get into a scoring area, because he's very, very efficient, as we can see in his 36 points a game. And then offensively, listen, you have to take care of the basketball, and you have to come down and you have to shoot it well. We talk about an efficient offense. You have to be very efficient and proficient and not turn it over and allow them to create offense off your turnovers.
You and I both had the chance to talk to Westview's head coach Rob Yoder on Monday morning at the state finals media day, and he said they're going to get some good looks. What we cannot have them do is get great second looks. And if the litany of things we told you about Trevon Bluiett wasn't enough after, you know, his great season, his fantastic career, he was the IBCA Player of the Week this week, because in addition to scoring 37 points, Bob, he had 17 rebounds in winning against Clarksville.
That's because he's virtually impossible to match up with in terms of his skill, his size, his ability to do things with and without the basketball. We obviously talk about what he does with the basketball, and I mentioned it, and I'll say it throughout the game. Watch how the game comes to him. He doesn't force things, Greg. You don't see him to make bad decisions. He's going to go 32 points and average 36 points a game. That in itself is impressive.
Park Tudor playing in their fourth 2A state championship game in the last 5 years. They and Westview are set for battle. Starting lineups in a matter of moments here on Fox Sports Indiana. You see that magnificent HD Jumbotron above us here at Bankers Life Fieldhouse? I'll simply read what it says on the screen. Honored to support Indiana's game at all levels. For the first time, the Indiana Pacers and the Indiana Fever sponsor both the boys and girls basketball state tournaments here in the state of Indiana. Greg Rakestraw, Bob Lovell, and Chris May with you. And now the PA voice of the Indiana State Finals. Here's Scott Gregg.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Indianapolis and Bankers Life Fieldhouse for the 104th Annual Boys Basketball State Finals. Our game this afternoon is for the Class 2A State Championship, featuring the Park Tudor Panthers and the Westview Warriors. Here are your rosters and starting lineups for today's 2A championship game. First for the Park Tudor Panthers. Number 10, Kobe Webster. Number 13, your roster and starting lineup for the Westview Warriors. Number 13, Darren. Number 51, Tim Miller. And the starting lineup for the Warriors of Westview at guard, a 5'10" senior, number 11, Jordan Bontrager. At guard, a 5'11" senior, number 21, Jamar Weaver. At guard, a 6-foot senior, number 35, Damon Hershberger. At forward, a 6'3" senior, number 15, Judah Zikafus. At forward, a 6'3" junior, number 41, Chandler Espy. Head coach of the 22-4 Warriors, Rob Yoder.
Our starting lineups brought to us by Subway. Then to focus on our head coaches. For Park Tudor, it is Kyle Cox. He has been a longtime assistant under the previous head coach in Ed Schilling. He is also the assistant athletic director at Park Tudor High School. He played in the 1A state championship game at Blue River Valley back in 2001. And Rob Yoder, his first state championship appearance as the head coach at Westview, his 11th season overall with an outstanding record of 189-80 in his days at Westview. Westview, as expected, brought an outstanding crowd with them from just east of the South Bend area.
These are two teams that have been here, Greg. We mentioned it before. I mean, Park Tudor, obviously, 2011 and 12 is the champs and runners-up in 2010. Westview was here in 99 and 2000 and won the championship back-to-back years, and we're here for their third time now. So they're not unfamiliar to success in both these programs.
Our outstanding officials for today's 2A state championship game, Eric Coburn, Ron McGriff, and Michael Zaire. Tremendous honor for them to be at this level of basketball as well. Park Tudor with the basketball. Bryce Moore with the handles here for the Panthers.
Well, both teams like to play man-to-man, Greg, and already you got a foul. You got a you have Damon Hershberger, who's matched up with Bluiett, and picks up a foul. I mean, we're 12 seconds into it. And I think what you'll see is you'll see multiple bodies rotate in and out on Trevon Bluiett. And
sometimes, Bobby, can be too open. There was so much attention on Bluiett that Shelton was all alone under the basket, and the ball went right through his hands.
A shaky start, to say the least, in the first 15 seconds.
This is Bon Traeger, who has the basketball for Westview.
Well, you're going to see it in his hands a lot today, Greg.
Leading scorer, leads them in assists as well, and nearly their leading rebounder. A do-it-all type of player for Westview. It's a Park Tudor program that primarily played zone in Ed Schilling's days as the head coach. They have now switched to more of a man-to-man team, and Hershberger with the bucket. And that's big. He's a young man that is not usually that big of a scoring threat for this ball club. Mack for three. The zone defense for Park Tudor may have changed over the last 2 years. Their ability to knock down jump shots has not.
And Alex Mack has been here with Trevon Bluiett in this ride. And, you know, you talk about experience, and he certainly has it in tournament time.
They have had so many deadly shooters over the last 4 and 5 years. Bon Traeger tries to answer, and Bluiett snares the rebound. This Park Tudor teammate is often get to a corner, wait for the ball to find you. Shelton tried the oop. Gibson able to track it down. An unconventional way to line up a three for Matt, but cannot get it to go.
Well, again, we talk about Westview likes to run a little tempo. They're an X and O execution half-court type of basketball team, and you see that early on in this game.
Bob, in talking with Rob Yoder, I asked him on Monday, I said, do you feel like you need to control the tempo in this game? And he said, no. If we get a good shot, we'll take it.
Right. And now, right. But again, in their offense, you'll see them be a little more judicious. Obviously, a little turnover here. But they're judicious in when they take it. And, again, we're early in this ball game. Their M.O., though, Greg, is they run great sets at half court. They execute it. They get the ball in the hands of Bon Traeger to help make decisions. And that's what's gotten them to this point.
Pull up from Bluiett. There's no good answer as far as how you guard him, but he'll simply read who's kind of on the ball at the point. He had a 6-inch advantage on Hershberg and went right up and over him.
We talked about it. He's going to take what's there. And you know, if he needs to penetrate, he'll penetrate. If he needs to get the little step back jump shot, and he'll take advantage of the things that are there.
The arrow points the way of Westview. And Rob Yoder wants his kids' energy a little bit higher. Just looked at Judah Zikapus and said, hey, let's go. Let's get this going.
Well, I think, you know, right now, I mean, the pace in half court has been a little slow. But you look at the pace now, it's not slow this time.
Gibson steal, Gibson hard foul. Hopefully he's okay. He pops right back up. And two free throws coming up here for Park Tudor.
How about Dwayne Gibson on the steal, the coast to coast, and finishes. Well, that's a hard foul, as we like to say. And, you know, Judah Zikafus with a hard foul.
Zikafus is a Division I level athlete. He's going to play baseball at new Division I member Grand Canyon University in Arizona next year.
I understand it. I mean, you know, it's certainly, and we talked about that. We will talk about it in the 3A matchup with the five Division I players at Greensburg. When you're successful, Greg, at the highest level, you know what winning's all about.
Good look at Kyle Cox on the sidelines. He qualified for the state finals in two sports in his athletic days. He was also a Division I level golfer at Ball State and played in the Gulf State Finals in 2002. Hershberger off the window and score.
Well, off the great pass. Doubled up the post, got the kick to Hershberger. Two big baskets for him right now.
And that's going to be a foul on bumping the cutter.
Well, here you see in that last play. I do not believe that the bank, in fact, was specifically open until now. But, again, that's a great pass out of the post by Chandler Aspen. Saw the double. And then the other part of it is, you know, give Hershberger credit for moving to an open spot.
Catch and shoot. Not that time, but Gibson corrals the long rebound. Shelton. Yet another offensive look, and Shelton with an NBA level three.
Well, Austin Shelton had a couple of good looks, but again, you look, Bluiett avoids the charge, allows things to come to him. Great domination on the part of the offensive boards by Park Tudor.
And as talked about, Wes, you said they had to control the offensive glass. Didn't do it that time down, and Park Tudor eventually made him pay.
You know, Bontrager a little quick on the trigger.
Bluiett the runner. And he's going to get whistled for a foul going for the rebound.
And again, you see this over and over. On a rebound, you'll see him coast to coast, make decisions, go to the rim. This is that flurry of great board work on the part of Park Tudor and the recipient, Austin Shelton for the three. And Bluiett doing what he does, Greg. Again, how do you stop that? I mean, you've got to get to him quickly. It's certainly easier said than done.
First look for Aspie. Gibson got a piece of that one. And Shelton's going to be fouled.
He got him on the pass.
Yeah. Ended up, instead of looking at the bucket, saw that Gibson was wide open.
Well, if you've seen Park Tudor play in these championships the last 3 years, you're right. You see spotted three-point shooters in the corners, and that has not changed.
Some of the names have changed. The way they play does not. Panthers early 9-4 lead here in the 2A state championship game.
Absolutely. I'm watching the cheerleaders. They're pretty good. And I love the shirts. The shirts are special.
The Westview Warriors making their first appearance here at Bankers Life Fieldhouse since it was Conseco Fieldhouse in the inaugural year that the boys basketball state championship games were played here back in 2000. Back-to-back state champs in 2A in 99 and 2000 for Westview. Trailing Park Tudor 9-4 here in the early going. Early substitution now for the Warriors. Darren Miller, a 6-foot senior, into the lineup. This game really yet to kind of get its rhythm going.
That's a great point. And I think because they haven't gotten – the game hasn't gotten its rhythm, the crowd hasn't gotten its rhythm either. And but it will. We're still early.
Shelton. And this is a Park Tudor team that will take and make a lot of threes. They average just under 10 threes a game, and they make 40% from distance.
Well, spacing the court is what they do, and when you have the player like Trevon Bluiett, you can space the court. And we talked about this, Greg, in the open. You got to be efficient offensively. You know, you got to come down. You can't have these type of unforced turnovers. You've got to come down. You got to take good shots. You know, you got to take care of the basketball. You cannot put the ball in the hands of Park Tudor after easy turnovers.
Zickafoos draws a defensive assignment on Bluiett. And the pull-up three is good.
Well, not much you can do. I mean, you got to respect the ability to put it on the floor and go to the rim. And, you know, the step-back three, it's kind of hard to defend.
Bluiett part of what many feel is a three-man race for Mr. Basketball. Trey Lyles we'll see in the 4A game tonight. James Blackman Jr. of Marion that is, of course, heading to Indiana University.
That would not be one I want to vote on. I think it's a three-way tie. How about that? How about it works out that way?
Gonna make Charlie Hall get three number one jerseys for the All-Star team this year.
Well, great job half-court defensively by Park Tudor. Jordan Bontrager on the deep rebound, but Bryce Moore's done a nice job of taking away his opportunities to this point.
That ball was kicked. Bryce Moore got a foot to it.
And you look at it, Bontrager averages 17 a game, and Bryce Moore, if you think about it, has negated his opportunities to, number one, catch it, and number two, do anything with it.
And this is a much different defensive look for Park Tudor than maybe fans have seen in years gone by. Let's sit back in that 2-3 zone and just almost make it impossible to get by him. Much more kind of in your chest defensively these days.
Well, it's a great point. And give Kyle Cox credit. I mean, you see this. You're thinking right now, if you're Dwayne Gibson, you pick this pocket. But to go back, Kyle Cox goes to his guys and says, look, you know, we're going to pick up the pace a little bit. I trust you. We have faith in what you're able to do. You know, they're still able to run the zone. But right now, if you play Park Tudor, you're going to go against full court pressure, half court pressure the entire game.
Bluiett mistimes the jump. Zickafoos had a good look but couldn't get it to go. Little fade back 15-footer by Bluiett does not go.
Maybe a forced shot for him. Really was kind of forced, but he hustles back to create something on the other end.
Westview now, though, with four turnovers here in the opening 6 minutes. Gibson a spot up three. Again, both teams still kind of struggling to find that range. Maybe having to wait through the overtime game beforehand. Kind of slowed things up for each of these two teams just a bit. Bontrager found some room to operate and score.
That's what you see in Jordan Bontrager. He's great. You know, it comes off a curl cut, really explosive, even without the basketball. Great move without it. Felt the contact, got the score.
Final minute of the opening quarter. Shelton. Great job by Bontrager. That's the textbook blockout. The ball should hit the floor. That's absolutely what happened.
That's just like in practice. That's the kind of move in practice where you go ahead and say, okay, let's knock down free throws and go because we can't get any better.
Three field goals so far for Westview. Just four for Park Tudor. 5 second count being applied, but Bontrager got rid of the basketball in plenty of time.
But watch Bryce Moore obviously try to create, Bontrager trying to create against Bryce Moore.
Love good look to Zickafoos, just couldn't get it to go. From half court in time, a little bit short. Neither team has reached their top gear just yet. After one quarter of play, Park Tudor 12 and Westview 6. It's the 2A state championship game, presented by the Indiana Pacers and the Indiana Fever. Well, it's good to see the Park Tudor cheerleaders are getting along with their opponents, because I saw a cheerleader fight between Park Tudor and Burbuff.
Well, I mean,
I
understand it was having a grandson at Burbuff, and, you know, when I went to that lacrosse match, I told you it took forever because the officials kept throwing flags over, and everybody was just yapping
at
each other. And
the Burbuff girls were doing full court, like, flips in front of the Park Tudor student section. The girl from Burbuff got a running start before she started her flip.
She get tackled?
Yeah. But she didn't get tackled. She got girl to step in front of her and just hip checked her.
Oh, my.
I mean, it was serious.
See? Burbuff, Park Tudor. Not enough money at those schools. Wow. I like this outfit. This is good.
Superheroes are good at stuff like that. Made sure he got the mask back on before the second quarter started. Quick look at our first quarter stats.
Well, it was an unspectacular quarter, if you will. Both teams, as you point out, trying to find their way along. And, you know, already Park Tudor has taken 10 attempts at the three and knocked down three.
Well, Park Tudor has been outstanding on the glass, and they've made the most of second and third chance opportunities.
Well, Trevon Bluiett again. You know, how do you match up? I mean, here is a kid. He just goes in. He's 6'6" and can score off the dribble. But if you're Westview right now, Greg, you can't allow too much distance. You got to continue to fight and get some things offensively. You know, tremendous move to the rim by Judah Zickerfus, just couldn't finish. You know what I mean? You got an eight. You're down eight early. 7.5 left in the first half, and you got to have, if you're Zickerfus, you got to try to somehow, some way on that attempt, you got to figure out how to knock it in.
I'm not sure if Westview has taken a bad shot yet.
No, really, they haven't. They just haven't gone for them. The other part of it is they're not a high-volume attempt type of team either. You know, you look, they're using clock at every possession.
Evan Frank in as the first substitution for Park Tudor. Bontrager, the pull-up jumper.
I think Bontrager really is the guy we know. He's got to be more assertive. He's really got to look more to the rim to try to create some things for himself and his teammates.
Pull up by Park Tudor is good. Bryce Moore with his first basket.
Well, I think, you know, after that break, you kind of feel a little bit more proficiency, a little more energy here in this second quarter.
Zickerfus again, good look, just can't find the range. Mack in a corner. Moore took it himself and just couldn't get the finish.
Had everything but the finish.
Pull-up jump shot. That one no good. And when Bluiett grabs the board, he leads the break. A hockey assist opportunity here. Pass to bucket of three for Park Tudor.
And they do it very well. It's something that you see a lot, obviously, with Bluiett's ability to get it off the rim and push it ahead.
You hear the phrase running the lanes on a fast break. For them, it's more like running to a spot and wait for the pass to come find you.
Well, you're going
to
spot in the corners and spot, if you can, at the wings. And then the idea is to look ahead and find guys who are spotted up and can knock down three.
A double-digit lead. Make it 13 with a chance to be 14.
Again, like we talked about, you know, and I know it's, I mean, people would say, well, in your keys to the game, yeah, be proficient on offense. Everybody wants to. But here's the reason why. If you don't knock down those shots, this is what Park Tudor does and does well, Greg. It's get out in transition and score on the break. They score in a multitude of ways. And so, yes, it is relatively simple to be proficient offensively, because this is your best defense, and that's having an offense that they have to an offense where Park Tudor has to take the ball out of the net rather than get it off the rim and go.
Andrew Yoder into the contest, a 6'1 sophomore. Gibson now with 4 points. He's the only player on either side to shoot a free throw yet today.
And see, now it's a 14-point deficit, and there's a lot of time left in this game.
Only Bontrager and Hirschberger have scored yet for Westview. Brody Jancy in there as well. There's a Bontrager three that half out and popped out. Frank with a block. He got some arm there, too, and it'll be two free throws for Westview.
How about the three that doesn't stay down? This maybe underscores the frustration level of Westview. That thing is in. It didn't stay in. But credit Zikafoos for being there again, doing the dirty work inside.
Zikafoos on the season, a 63% free throw shooter.
That's a miss. You know what? Goes down as a miss. Can't worry, but just it's a miss.
That would be the microcosm of this game so far for Westview.
I think that even underscores the frustration better than the three that didn't stay. I think you're 100% right.
And that one does fall. One bounce and a stick. 22-9, Park Tudor, a 13-point lead. And that's going to be Zikafoos on the hold.
Well, your option is to try to deny, and by deny, you might try to lock him up, literally, and because when he catches it, he's pretty deadly.
Zikafoos now with two fouls, and of the five fouls whistled so far against Westview today, three of them have been off the ball, a player trying to slow down the progress of Trevon Bluiett.
Yeah, and I think if you're Rob Yoder, you probably let Zikafoos stay. I mean, he looks like he's going to right now. You got to roll the dice. You're already deep down. And down further with the big three by Trevon Bluiett.
And that is a shot you simply cannot guard.
No.
Zikafoos, the turn, hits the side of the backboard. Put back too strong. They're going to get Frank for going over the back, and that'll be his second foul in short order for the Park Tudor Panthers.
Well, he's come in and played hard. I mean, you know, he's gotten aggressive on the rim. That one's kind of a tough one for you to take because, you know, you're hustling and trying to do things, but you know, now they go small, bring back Austin Shelton. We know what he's done to this point, and we know he's a weapon from three every time down.
Zikafoos will sit with two fouls. Starting five back on the floor for Park Tudor. This is Chandler Aspie, second leading scorer for Westview, but no points just yet.
Yeah, and they clearly need him to get engaged, more assertive and engaged. Get a little two-man game if they can on one side with Aspie and with Bontrager.
Aspie, honorable mention, All-State as an underclassman by the IBCA.
Yeah.
Bontrager, everything but the bucket and Aspie.
You love the kid. I mean, just a tremendous penetration, but you see that a lot. Aspie cleaning up. They need to get more of that, more to the rim, more active.
Bluiett left alone, and that is a common result when that is said.
Did we mention how easy it is, if you look at it, for him to get 36 a game? Because, again, he's forced one shot up to this point, and he has plenty of opportunities.
A little trap here in the half court by Park Tudor. Three in the opposite corner is good by Yoder.
You know, Andrew Yoder, nice spotted three, good ball rotation. We talk about it. They're an execution type of team. Here's an unforced error that you need to take advantage of if you're Westview.
A rare turnover committed by Park Tudor.
Penetrate pitch, relocate. That's textbook stuff right there, Greg. And, you know, again, off the catch, Andrew Yoder with a nice look.
Westview, a 39% three-point shooting team this year. He's trying to stay within shouting distance here of Park Tudor in the opening half. You'd like to get this out of single digits by halftime if you're Westview. Opening up some room for Aspie, and he got hammered by Gibson. The two free throws will be coming up here for Chandler Aspie.
Well, we talked about it. Aspie has to be, and his teammates have started to look for him a little bit more, but you notice he's become much more assertive. The screen, the slip, the post, got the ball, took it up with some authority, and drew the foul. Now, obviously, need to knock down a couple of free throws.
Aspie, just a junior, 16 points and 6 rebounds a game. Barely grazed the rim on that one. A little better rhythm that time, and that'll also lead us to the media timeout. Park Tudor in control early. They lead Rob Yoder's Westview Warriors squad 28-15 here on Fox Sports Indiana.
Welcome back from the floor, Bankers Life Fieldhouse. 3:41 left in the second quarter. Park Tudor leads Westview 28-15. I'm Chris May, joined courtside by Indianapolis Mayor Greg Ballard. First of all, Mayor, great to see you here, out for some good high school hoops today.
It's always fun to see the championship games and the excitement of people coming into this particular facility. It's a thrill for everybody.
I also know, obviously, Park Tudor and Marion County team. Later tonight, Indianapolis Tech carrying the Indianapolis banner as well. That's got to be exciting.
It is. I have another event tonight, but I think I'll be able to get over here and see most of that game. I'm anxious to see both teams win, if at all possible.
Obviously, a huge basketball weekend, not only the high school state championships, the NCAA regionals. What does this mean, not only financially, but from a PR standpoint for the city?
Well, everybody knows about Indiana and basketball, and it's really about putting on great events and multiple great events at the same time, and the city knows how to do that sort of thing.
You care to make a prediction for tonight's 4A game?
Well, I have to go with Tech, obviously.
Greg, back to you.
Thank you very much. Jamar Weaver to the scoring column with the three, and Westview's got it back to a 10-point game. Well, for about 3 seconds they did. Pull-up jump shot by Moore makes it a dozen.
Yeah, but you like the energy, though, coming out for Westview. They're much more assertive. And now tell me if you've seen this from Park Tudor, a little 2-3 zone, Greg. You know, change of tempo, change of look. You know, Kyle Cox recognizing that this Westview team's more assertive on the offensive end, throws them a little different look defensively.
Aspie looking to do work down low and gets it to go. And seems now that finally Westview in some sort of offensive flow.
Absolutely. I mean, and now you see why Aspie's averaging nearly 16 a game. We mentioned needs to be more engaged, more involved, and he certainly has been in the last 2 or 3 minutes. Having said all that, though, you're Westview and you're still down 10. But you like the energy on their part in this second quarter.
Gibson a deep three. And Bontrager the rebound. Gibson got a hand on it and knocked it free. Out of bounds to Westview. Evan Frank now will check back in for Park Tudor. He's been their only sub that has played today. And they really only want to play six, if at all possible.
Just good quick hands on the part of Dwayne Gibson, because you know Jordan Bontrager can get to the rim in a hurry.
Aspie goes right to work on Frank and score.
You don't think he was listening to me, do you? Because I'm going to tell you what, in the last 2 minutes, he's been everywhere, and to his teammates' credit, they've gotten him the ball where he can do something.
The Westview crowd behind us making some well-deserved noise. They're on an 11-2 run. Aspie and Bluiett kind of going at it back and forth. And there is Blewett's answer.
He always he comes up with that answer quite a bit, does he not?
There was a bit of chest to chest, and Blue just kind of nodded his head and went right at him, and Aspie goes right back at the other end. The battle has been joined. It's a 9-point lead for Park Tudor.
Well, it has been, and I think that's, you know, what we kind of expected was more of that, what we have right now.
And that'll be a blocking foul on Brody Jancy.
So Brody Jancy thinks he got where he needed to be. That's just a tough call. We understand, obviously, that's the toughest one in the game. We've got the benefit right here. Still kind of leaning. That's a tough one. Clearly, if you're Westview, Greg, we know where you come down on this decision. And if you're Park Tudor, you got the right guy at the line. That's a tough one.
I would say that is the definition of a bang-bang play.
Absolutely.
And the Westview folks would say, ball does not lie. A chance to slice into this 9-point lead.
Well, Park Tudor has come out of the zone after a couple of quick baskets by Chandler Aspie, too.
The lead was at one point in time 17 at 28-11. Weaver a deep three, and Bontrager the board. And Aspie goes to work again and scores yet again.
I'll tell you what, no one has an answer right now for Chandler Aspie. Just as Westview is having a difficult time answering Trevon Bluiett, nobody's answered Chandler Aspie.
11 for Aspie, all the second quarter. Tough shot, Bluiett, and he's fouled.
They're going to get him on attack if he, you know, he's emotional, I understand, but He did. If you see on this replay, you'll see that he gets that contact after the shot. I mean, he's fired up, he's pumped up, he's defending, and the forearm, the shove, clearly a foul. But you're in the moment right now. You're really excited about what you've been doing, and you make that foul. It's all right.
Now, what the discussion is going on the sidelines is that should that have been a two-shot foul or a three-shot foul? It was ruled to be a three-shot foul. However,
if we can see the replay again, is a two.
His foot was over the line.
Yeah.
But we do have replay technology available to the officials.
We're looking at, yeah, that's clearly a two.
Yeah, they only have end-of-game replays here in the high school state finals.
Right.
So it has to be the discussion of the officials have to have a consensus whether it should be a three or a two.
Well, you know, again, it's tough. It's a tough situation for all the officials involved. And again, you know, we're now in a world where they're going to go with three, clearly to the displeasure of the Westview fans. And we have it easy, Greg. We have the benefit of being able to watch multiple replays.
Again, in the college game,
yeah,
you would go back and look at that.
Absolutely.
And in the high school game, what opportunities, other than a state finals, would you normally have to do something just like that?
Yeah, in federation rules, because of, you know, the monetary issues and all the things involved, you'd, I suppose, love to be able to do that. But, again, this has developed quite a controversy in terms of the NCAA and the reliance on the monitor. You know, it does impact the flow of the game. And the referees, like players and coaches, make mistakes. Everybody out there is going to make a mistake. Except you and I have done a flawless broadcast. We haven't made any mistakes yet. But
I think the broadcaster jinx would then apply to us with a statement like that, too.
I think you're probably right.
So back to a nine-point game. As Bluiett makes two out of three. Weaver, but he is fouled. And two shots coming up here for Jamar Weaver.
Well, Jamar Weaver was in the catch-and-shoot mode. I mean, you see him come down. You know, he gets a little screen, a little brush screen. You know, you see him come up, little turn. Fire. Clearly, Austin Shelton not there quickly enough, got him on the elbow.
Weaver, a young man that's going to play baseball at Huntington University next year.
It's a great choice. Tell you what, you want to teach somebody how to shoot a free throw, watch this stroke. Watch how he sets this up. This is good looking. This is a good looking free throw. Huh? It looked like you. And I did put the hex on him, didn't I?
Rebound, though, by Westview, and a foul whistled against Park Tudor. There'll be two more free throws heading the way of the Warriors.
Guys in white have more energy right now, Greg, clearly. And they've had more energy in this quarter. And Park Tudor can be thankful. Some big threes by Trevon Bluiett. Because Westview has clawed their way back into it and have really worked hard in this quarter.
Brody Jancy unfortunately left that one short.
And free throws have not been their friends right now.
Three of seven is Westview from the line. Blew at the rebound. Fires ahead to Shelton. Shelton, pass a little bit too long. Great idea. Just couldn't finish it off. Again, Park Tudor led by as many as 17. Westview has sliced that lead in half. It's currently 8. Chris May standing by with Kyle Cox.
Thank you very much, Coach. Your reactions to the first half?
Well, we're really struggling to guard the post with Aspie. We got him in foul trouble early, and then we know he's the left shoulder guy, and we didn't do a very good job of that. We had some times where we could try to maybe blow this thing open a little bit when we went up 13. Coming out of timeout, we weren't very good, and then kind of a dumb mistake right there. Luckily, they missed both free throws.
Outside of strategy, any other messages to your guys in the locker room?
Just finish the – I mean, we talk about winning battles. I mean, we got to win this battle and finish the war off the right way.
Thank you, Kyle.
Yep.
Chris, thank you very much. Park Tudor raced out to a big early lead, in large part powered by Trevon Bluiett. He's got 18, but Chandler Aspie's provided an answer. His 11 second quarter points have brought the Warriors back with an 8 here on Fox Sports Indiana.
Thank you.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for your halftime trivia challenge. Presented by Sports Medicine. And we take you to center court for the trivia challenge.
Time to review our keys to this game, presented by our friends at Wilson, the official ball of the IHSAA. Bob, has Park Tudor followed the game plan?
I wouldn't say so defensively, Greg. I think Kyle Cox will tell his kids we need to get more pressure. They have gotten out in transition and have benefited from it, but defensively, certainly need to ramp it up.
And for Westview, tell us how the Warriors have followed this plan of attack.
They have not done as well as you can in terms of finding him, finding Trevon Bluiett in transition. Offensively, the efficiency really went up dramatically in that second quarter and has allowed him to really get back into this game.
Again, our keys of the game brought to us by Wilson. More win. Halftime festivities continue in a matter of moments. The state championship games presented by the Indiana Pacers and Indiana Fever.
Welcome back courtside from Bankers Life Fieldhouse. Halftime of the 2A competition. Park Tudor leads 35-27. I'm Chris May, pleased to be joined by Greg Schinkel, representing the management of the Indiana Pacers and the Indiana Fever. Greg, first of all, congratulations. Another great day, another great event in this wonderful and beautiful facility.
Well, thank you very much. It is. It's exciting for us and great crowds for this morning session already. A great game that went into overtime the first time, and it's all about Indiana basketball, and it's a great place to be.
And I know the organization is very proud. The Pacers sponsoring the IHSA Boys State Tournament, the Indiana Fever presenting the IHSA Girls State Tournament. What does that mean to this organization, obviously to our state?
Well, basketball, as you know, is Indiana's game. So for the Pacers and the Fever to be able to partner with the IHSAA is so meaningful, and it's so important, I think, to everywhere in the state and to our organization, right down to every employee, and we really value this. It's a great partnership.
Well, on behalf of the IHSA, we want to thank the Indiana Pacers and the Indiana Fever.
Thank you, and we're tickled to death you gave us this opportunity. It's wonderful. Thank you.
Once again, we are at the half, the 2A competition. Park Tudor on top, 35-27 from Bankers Life Fieldhouse. Back after this.
Fans of all ages having a great time here at Bankers Life Fieldhouse. Park Tudor, an 8-point lead. Time for our first half stats. They are our first half highlights, brought to us by Methodist Sports Medicine in collaboration with IU Health, the official sports medicine provider to the IHSAA. And really, for each team, there was one dominant figure.
Well, Chandler Aspie, obviously, in the second quarter for Westview, had a spectacular time. Multitude of ways, but more than anything, he was aggressive. You see him in the paint, you know, turning to his left and right shoulder and making big plays. On the other end, how do you stop that? One bounce, pull-up jump shot by Trevon Bluiett. Here it is, crossover, three, knockdown jump shot. He's a perimeter-oriented guy. He feels the pressure, steps back, knocks down a three again, Greg. And, again, you can get up, you can put pressure on him, you can do what you have, but it's hard to stop him.
Bluiett with 18 points in the first half. Aspie, 11 points on 5 of 5 shooting in the second quarter. Our first half stats brought to us by Subway.
Well, I think the big thing right there, Westview, 9 of 21 from the field. The big key, though, Park Tudor, 7 of 15 from 3. That's given them this cushion. You could say there's been a reliance, maybe too much of a reliance on the 3-point shot, and I'm sure that Coach Cochran will try to talk to his kids about maybe getting it inside out a little bit more in this second half.
It's a Park Tudor team, though, that, again, is a 40% 3-point shooting team. They make 10 per game this season. We're back in just a moment. Second half next on Fox Sports Indiana.
You do want it, though. You want it taped? Okay. I still don't see him. The team's out here, obviously, but... It'll be a quick hitter, one question, obviously. Here he comes. Do you need me to give a countdown? Ready. Yep. Head Coach Yoder here from Westview after the break. Coach, what was your message to your guys?
Well, I thought after the first quarter when we played more like we normally play, where our jump shooters shoot jump shots, and we are more patient on the offensive end, we were better. But if we got guys shooting jump shots and aren't jump shooters, that plays into their hands and helps them. So we got to make sure we who we have been all year.
Thanks for your time. Good luck in the second half.
Thank you.
Before we start the third quarter, a quick word with Westview head coach Rob Yoder from Chris May.
Head coach Yoder here from Westview after the break. Coach, what was your message to your guys?
Well, I thought after the first quarter when we played more like we normally play, where our jump shooters shoot jump shots, and we are more patient on the offensive end, we were better. But if we got guys shooting jump shots and aren't jump shooters, that plays into their hands and helps them. So we got to make sure we who we have been all year.
Thanks for your time. Good luck in the second half.
Thank you.
There you see Jordan Bontrager, just 4 points for Bontrager. But again, the offense was all about Aspie in that second quarter. It's part of the reason why Westview has gotten back in this game.
No, clearly. But, you know, Bontrager will, I think, continue to amp up his game in the second half.
Patience being shown here by Park Tudor leads to a deep Bluiett three. A Westview bucket here. This is suddenly a two-possession game.
Well, I mean, again, you know, they have just battled back. We talk about them as a half-court execution type of basketball team, and they have been.
Hirschberger. This is reverting back to first quarter form, but this time they get the bucket to go, and an and-one opportunity to cut the lead to five.
You know, Greg, at the half, points in the paint, something you talk about. Westview was 14-2, now 16-2. This is just great effort. This is coming out of the locker room, being determined and having a great effort. And, you know, Hirschberger early started out pretty well and was kind of silent in the end of the first half. But came up big, big three. You're right. You got a two-possession game right now to start the half.
Hirschberger, a young man that had battled through a knee injury from last season. You see the bulky brace on his right knee, a torn ACL last year. Slowed him at the start of the year, but having a big game here, and this is his final game as a Westview Warrior as a senior.
Yeah, Park Tudor against the man-to-man at half court, a little flex action in their half court, and no continuation here in the high school rank.
Even though we're in an NBA building.
Even though we're in an NBA building, and we're almost all conditioned, but again, great penetration on the part of Bryce Moore. Nobody steps over and stops it. But you watch the action, there'll be back screens, not a lot of down screens in this half-court flex approach offensively by Park Tudor. More of the back screen and the customary three-point shot.
Eighth made three by Park Tudor. Shelton's second. He is the third leading scorer on this Park Tudor ball club. Played at Avon High School before now, spending his final 2 years as a high school varsity player at Park Tudor.
Well, you got Aspie out front, but you're going to see him pass and then throw back screen to get back inside. Just like the pace. I mean, like the pace for your Westview. You like the pace. You like the tempo. And you like that guy to have the ball in his hands.
That's the guy you want shooting it. Behind the back to Bluiett. And one. There's your highlight reel in one play.
There you go. I'll tell you what, they've been working on this one quite a while. But this is transition. That is a big-time pass. Now, I don't care who you are. That behind the back there, that is a big-time pass.
I get the feeling you and I just made the national highlight show.
I hope we did.
For nothing that we did of our own talent.
I would hope we did.
Made it nonetheless. Bluiett with 21.
You mean to whip around behind the back to a guy who knows how to finish, too.
Austin Shelton, known for his three-point marksmanship. His behind-the-back pass accuracy is also pretty impressive. Back to a double-digit lead for the Panthers. Aspie trying to go to work. He's did in the second quarter.
Yeah, you saw Aspie get that second body, too. You know, you obviously had him one-on-one with Dwayne Gibson, but got a little bit of help very, very quickly on the pass to the post. I love it. Love the bump to get open.
Bluiett there to provide help and just did enough to get Aspie's way.
And again, Westview has a great opportunity, Greg. Just can't close the door on it.
Good kick out by Bluiett. And a better conversion by Bryce Moore.
You know, the three now, though, these are coming off of inside out. You know, with their flex, they'll space the court, they'll work inside, and Bluiett on a great pass out of the post.
That's a 9-0 run on three trips by Park Tudor, and now a steal. But Zikafoos is there to knock it away. And then a foul whistle. Bluiett will shoot two.
Well, Zikafoos came from out of nowhere. You talk about another highlight? Watch this one. He gets every bit of this. Ball's not on the rim, on the board by the time he gets there. So it's a legal play. He gets it in the air. That is a big-time defensive play. Trevon Bluiett right there to clean up the.
Bluiett misses the free throw. He's now 4 of 6 from the line today on the season, an 81% shooter. And Zikafoos will be a Division I athlete next year, and that play showed every bit of that athleticism.
I would think so. You know, great time. You saw him at the free throw line, size it up, get himself ready, and he made the great play.
Westview has to look up the scoreboard and be thinking, we've done a lot of things well the last couple of quarters. And we're down by 15.
Yeah, I mean, the three straight threes, that's hard to bounce back from. But you clearly can't trade two for three. That's the problem, one of the conundrums you find yourself in right now.
Park Tudor over 50% from three-point range. They are 9 of 17. And Bontrager has it stripped away. A look ahead pass to Bluiett. And one.
I think Mr. Bluiett may have sent a message to Zikafoos on this one that, yeah, I know you got the last one, but I don't think you're going to get this one. And you see it here on the steal, the look ahead, great catch, and we'll go to the free throw line. Tell you what, we've seen some plays, some literally highlight reel type plays already, Greg.
It is a 13-0 run that Park Tudor is on right now to suddenly put a major gap in this game.
And it was in a hurry. And the problem is, you know, can Westview score quickly enough and get enough stops defensively to climb back in with 4 minutes left in the third?
The 18-point lead, now the largest of the game. Previously it was 17 at 28-11. It's a Park Tudor team that has won the last two Marion County Championships. Looking for their third state crown in the last 4 years.
Great pass, just a tremendous pass. Oh, I love the pass to the post.
Aspie fouled, he'll shoot two.
How about Andrew Yoder? A great pass to the post. You know, Aspie does a nice job of holding off the defender inside. I will tell you what, though, for Westview, Greg, Jordan Bontrager's got to come alive. They have to have him come alive. And part of the problem for Jordan Bontrager has been Bryce Moore, who has really taken him out of this game in the second half.
And with that made free throw, we will go to the media timeout. 16-point lead for Park Tudor. And it has been impressive, to say the least. Bluiett has 25 here on Fox Sports Indiana. Not exactly a basketball powerhouse until the last five seasons. Park Tudor making their fourth appearance in the last 5 years here in the 2A state championship game. Located on the corner of 71st and College on the north side of Indianapolis. Say hello to my good friend Brad Lennon, athletic director at Park Tudor School. It has been a pleasure to spend a lot of time around that campus the last few years as they have turned into, again, an absolute juggernaut in 2A basketball. Shelton, the pull-up jumper is good.
A little different part of his repertoire. We know him as a three-point shooter. A couple of bounces for a good look.
Bontrager forced the issue. Aspie, first shot, no. Second shot, no. Westview still fighting, just can't get the looks to fall.
And it underscores the frustration, Greg. I mean, being assertive, getting in there, doing everything except knocking down the jump shot.
Catch and shoot for Bluiett. Shelton there for the rebound and score.
A long rebound creates interesting opportunities, and you give Austin Shelton credit for being right there and getting the easy layup.
The largest lead now grows to 20 for the Panthers. A deep three by Bontrager is good. His first made three-pointer today and his first points since early in the second quarter. And then Bontrager gets whistled for a blocking foul.
It's the first clean look Bontrager's had in the second half, Greg. I mean, again, you go back to Bryce Moore's lockdown on him right now. That's the first time he's really been able to get in the catch and shoot. And they've negated his dribble penetration to the rim.
Bontrager last week, an Indiana Basketball Coaches Association all-state level player. He was one assist away from a triple-double last week as Bluiett gets another basket. Bontrager's line last week, 18 points, 12 boards, and 9 assists.
Yeah, and just got the little lean there at the end to try to draw the charge, but that's a stat line. That's a week's work for a lot of people, what he did last Saturday.
Aspie, that's a foul on Mack.
Yeah, it is. You know, good little on big cross screen. If you basically you send Jamar Weaver, a little cross screen on the baseline for Aspie. Little on big, freeze him up, good pass, chance to go to the line. Key now is get to the free throw line, get the clock stop, score with the clock stop, try to climb yourself back in this.
The question I think becomes for Westview, and when you're down 17 points, you need buckets, but you also have to get stops. And how does that happen against a team that is this offensively solid as Park Tudor?
And the other problem is they're so quick, and transition is so important to what they do. Can you pick up the pace, and can you go get them full court?
Look ahead pass to Weaver. And Weaver traveled. Kind of measured his steps to see where Bluiett was coming from.
He knew where he was, and Trevon Bluiett creates that turnover. But, you know, it's a great look at him. That's the idea. You look ahead, and here you see him coming into frame. Whoops. You know, 2 foot jump stop, you got it. He just kind of shuffled the foot.
Mack for three. His third 3-point field goal.
Well, dribble penetration, Greg, we know it will hurt you. You know, and again, Shelton gets in, kicks to the corner, knocked down three.
Good rebound by Yoder. Bontrager again. Now Bluiett will lead the break for Park Tudor.
Yeah, with big numbers.
Somehow finds an open man in the corner in Bryce Moore. And a timeout will be taken by Park Tudor. It is a 30-second timeout.
And suddenly this thing, Greg, has just gone to 23. And you see it, you know, the contact, the no call, the throw to the corner, and a big basket, different angle. Same thing. Bryce Moore, you know, offensively has not had a big day, has had a massive day defensively in what he's done to Jordan Bontrager.
With a quarter left to go, Park Tudor has already set a new 2A game record in terms of threes made. And the previous two record holders were Westview in 2000 and Park Tudor 2 years ago in 2012, 11 threes made. A quick look at the Westview Warriors, Topeka, the city. More like the town that Westview hails from.
Beautiful LaGrange County in the northern part of the state.
Part of the Northeast Corner Conference, in which Westview went 8-1 this season, making their third ever appearance in the high school boys basketball state championship game.
And now Park Tudor has come back and gone to their 2-3 zone.
11 threes, by the way, is the 2A record. 15 is the overall record. Rochester had that, with Bruce Grimm Jr. hitting 8 of them a few years ago. Aspie now with 17.
Moore said, I heard you say I wasn't doing that well offensively, so here's one for you.
Moore will be the star of the show next year at Park Tudor. He is just a junior. Frank swats down and picks up the foul.
Well, they got some guys coming back. I mean, they have some guys who played a lot, but there will be a guy wearing number 22 not coming back. And frankly, I think he's been here for 6 or 7 years, to be honest.
Bluiett a senior, Shelton a senior, and Alex Mack a senior for Park Tudor. The three of their top four players will graduate off of this team.
And those guys know how to knock down threes, too.
...19 for Aspie, and all of them coming in the second or third quarter.
Now you see Rob Yoder's moved his guys up 2-2-1, little three-quarter court. You have to. I mean, you gotta do this, and you gotta try to find ways to slow down the dribble and slow down the three.
Panthers will hold for a final shot, or not. And when you get an open shot, generally this offense, you take it.
Look, I'm thinking if you've knocked down three now, or you know, that Matt is your third one, if you're Bryce Moore, go ahead and take it. You're in the flow.
12th made three for the Panthers. Miller fires one up off the rim and no good. This one is all Park Tudor. Here's the Panthers are on their way to a third state title in 4 years. It's the 2A state championship game presented by the Indiana Pacers. 30-point third quarter by Park Tudor. One shy of the 2A record set by Jimtown some 10 seasons ago. 65-41 is the score. Park Tudor in front. If you're Westview, if you've got one final run in you, it's got to come now. And there'll be a foul whistled on the floor. Mack will be picked up for the foul. Quick look at our stats through three quarters of play.
Just look at one line. Okay. 12 of 21 from three. And that pretty much says it all.
How about two turnovers for Park Tudor?
That's pretty impressive. I'll give you that.
Darren Miller, the senior, has yet to score today. He is a 61% shooter on the year.
Good point, though. Two turnovers in three quarters. But Greg, 12 of 21. By any measure.
You combine those two and you get a 23-point lead.
Yeah, you really do. Now it's a little 1-2-2 three-quarter court trap. A little better. You get better angles, better coverage in terms of trapping the ball out of this one. Didn't fall back man-to-man.
Deep three, blew it. And that'll be a foul whistle against Bryce Moore of Park Tudor. Sixth team foul against the Panthers.
I would think in terms of the second half, maybe the first thing Bryce Moore did wrong. Knocked down three in a row. He's defended well. Park Tudor comes out of its zone, goes man-to-man, puts a little more pressure on Westview. The Westview's got to get going quickly. Little flex action. They've got to start really now, Greg, going more to the rim, try to get some quicker hitters like this.
Aspie and blew at the board. Now a 3-on-2 break.
Great decision. Shelton, maybe earlier in the game, would have gone ahead and continued, but now just backs it out, runs some offense.
Like you described the end of a football game, if you're Park Tudor, you just want the clock to keep running. Good way of doing that is having Bluiett make yet another bucket.
Yeah, if you're Park Tudor, though, you thinking about Tech, Bloomington North last week, where you went to the bench and things went a little bit crazy score-wise? You know, Aspie has a nice look that doesn't go.
Outstanding feed by Moore, but Shelton says, hey, let's back it out. Frank to the bucket. The first layup would not go. Gibson on the crash, and Aspie will track down the loose ball.
Crash is what Gibson did. I mean, just went at it hard.
Three by Miller. Weaver the rebound for Westview. Now Aspie lets fire from 16, and that also is short. You're Park Tudor, you're trying to play whistle-free for as long as possible.
Well, I mean, you are, but I also think, you know, you're trying to continue to play at the level you've played like that. And again, if you got it, you know, you're a smart guy. You tell me how to stop that. I'm willing to listen to you.
I've seen them play a lot the last 4 years, and I do not have an answer.
Well, the folks in the A-10, Big East are going to try to figure it out. Good hoop. Andrew Yoder with a knockdown three. Tell you what, they keep fighting. They just keep playing hard. But have no answer on the defensive end right now to a Park Tudor team that's really in offensive rhythm.
Park Tudor has the record for margin of victory in a 2A game against Bowman Academy 2 seasons ago with 22. Yoder brings it back to, or Weaver, excuse me, to his second three. He's got 7. Makes it 71-48.
Well, there were similarities in that Bowman game, Greg, in the sense that once Park Tudor gets on a run, you know, and it's fueled in large part by consecutive threes, multiple threes sequentially, which is what they're able to do, and it's tough. And they got him on, they got Aspie on the hook. I think it just adds to the frustration. But here you see, how about Bluiett? again, from three, the spin move to the rim. And now Kyle Cox going to make some moves. I think he'll save Bluiett for one last trip. He'll make his substitution as a singular substitution.
37 points, the record by an individual in the 2A state finals. Tyler Cook of Winchester had that 6 years ago. Bluiett currently at 33. Bontrager tips it away from Bluiett for a moment, but gets the basket there. He's got 35.
Do you say that, now it's 35. You don't dare say just another game, but statistically it's another game for him.
It's an average afternoon. That's his average. Bontrager, no.
Obviously anything but average, but statistically speaking, it clearly is.
And that'll be a foul on Aspie, and I think a little frustration starting to show, and understandably so for Westview.
Absolutely.
Sloan Stearman, a senior who plays as a reserve for Park Tudor, about to enter the game. And for Aspie, that'll be his fifth foul. Not the way you want to exit a state championship game. However, you love the effort the young man gave. 19 points for Aspie. Made his last seven free throws as well.
Earned every one of them. Gave him that great lift in that second quarter when they made their run. And he deserves the applause because he's played hard and has one more year in his career. And Sloan Stearman has the bloodline. Grandfather Bill, the legendary coach at Columbus North.
Missed free throw by Bryce Moore. It makes one of two. And that'll lead us to our meeting of timeout. 3:39 left to play. Speaking of threes, Park Tudor about to claim that third basketball state crown here on Fox Sports Indiana. This one is kind of playing out almost exactly like we thought it would. I thought there was one team that had a chance to beat them, Clarksville.
Yeah.
I think
you're right.
And just because of the way that I saw Park Tudor not care about playing defense against Verbuff, I'm like, you know what?
Yeah.
Clarksville can beat them if they play that way. And they
because they can score.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's what happens when you have a guy that will probably at least get a sniff of the NBA play.
Love the chant I just heard from the Westview student section. They were saying, thank you, Jazz Band. They appreciated the soundtrack they've heard throughout the course of this game. And Bob and I would also say they've done a whale of a job.
They've been outstanding. They really have.
Westview has emptied the bench, and Park Tudor, I don't think, is too far away from doing the same. Missed three by Cody Littweiler is up and no good. And the ball out of bounds to Westview.
Well, it's been an amazing run for Park Tudor, Greg. I mean, think about this. And they've been here a lot.
they lost to Wheeler
right
in 2010, then defeated Bishop Knoll in 11, and blitzed Bowman Academy in 2012.
And then uncharacteristically did not make it last year.
Yeah, they had fits with Broadripple, who beat
Absolutely.
Them twice, once at the end of the regular season and during the sectional. It's kind of been the one blip, so to speak, on the resume for Park Tudor. Bluiett a three. Give Bluiett the new 2A scoring record with 38.
And you'll see a substitution right now. As if on cue. The only thing that might have been better would be the steal and the thunderous dunk, but what a spectacular career, for heaven's sakes.
Ball goes out of bounds. Andy Foster going to go check in for Park Tudor. One last look here for Bluiett. Bluiett will stay out for now. It is Mack that's going to get the curtain call. And looks like Alex, one more is coming.
Yeah, Alex Mack and Trevon Bluiett get the trifecta. That's pretty impressive stuff.
Three state championships in Trevon's career. Nick Beeson, a senior, will enter in his place. You saw the graphic. Park Tudor, a 2A state finals record with 13 threes today. And the final 2.5 minutes here are for both sides to make sure that all of their seniors get a curtain call, see how many young men they can get in the game. Jackson a miss, and Zikafoos the rebound for Westview.
You know, I mentioned in halftime maybe they had relied too much on the three, and I think at certain times they did, but in the second half they just knocked them down and did them in great fashion, and was a huge part of this big win.
Steps called against Jackson. That officially goes as just the third turnover of the game for Park Tudor. And a giveaway for Westview. They haven't had too many of those. That's just their 10th.
You know what? It's been a pretty well played, I mean, cleanly played game. Not a lot of turnovers, not a lot of fouls. The officials have done a remarkable job. Maybe save 1 3-point or 2-point shot and get the dig in, I suppose. But you know, it's been a very impressive day for the Park Tudor Panthers.
38-12. You saw the graphic on your screen for Trevon Bluiett. Deep three that does not go. That was Beeson.
Nick Beeson is a senior thinking, you know what, last time around I'm going to get a look at it.
And the basket is up and good. That's Chase Anderson, a sophomore.
Got the nice turnaround, went to that right shoulder. I like it.
Zikafoos with the steal. And Zikafoos with the lay-in. Tough day for him offensively, his first field goal.
But he's played hard. You know what? He's been active, and it's hard to believe that's the first field goal of the day for him because he's done so many other good things.
27, the current margin. That'd be the largest in 2A. Would not be the largest in the class basketball era. Jackson with the three.
How about the rookie?
A star of the future at Park Tudor High School.
How about the 6'6 freshman from the corner?
Bontrager with a three. And we have a timeout literally just taken just to sub guys in and out.
Get Bontrager out and also to get Zikafoos out. And listen, Jordan Bontrager is one of the premier guards in our state.
Quick look forward as Bontrager sees his Westview career come to an end. Marquette Catholic a winner this morning. Greensburg and Bowman, Tech and Lake Central. All four heavy hitters, and we expect a packed house tonight. Make sure you join us at 6 o'clock for our coverage here on Fox Sports Indiana. Brandon Tiasim in the game now for Park Tudor. Cade Miller and Tim Miller in the game for Westview. And this is Tim Miller able to grab the basketball. And he'll take it all the way down and score. And this shot up and rattled home. Kobe Webster, a freshman. And yes, we're getting to the age where people have named their kids Kobe after Kobe Bryant. That one goes, that one does not. And this one has come to an end. All Park Tudor this afternoon. Three championships in 4 years for the Panthers. They win handily, 84-57 over Westview. Handshakes between these two sides for Kyle Cox. It is his third state title as part of the Park Tudor program, his first as the head coach.
Well, it's an impressive display of offensive talent. And that you like, again, Kyle put his stamp on this team, extending the court, making them more of a full court type team, and look at the results. And there are not enough superlatives, I think, to toss in the direction of Trevon Bluiett in the not only today but throughout the entire year and throughout his entire career. And this has been the dominant 2A basketball team in our state, clearly, for the last 3 years.
There are many things that you would put on the resume of Trevon Bluiett in terms of his case for Mr. Basketball. At the top of the list would be, in my 4 years, I won 3 state championships.
There's no question. And, you know, he is that quintessential star player who makes people around him better. When they need him, he can score. I mean, we talked about it all day. It's amazing. Get the ball off the rim, take it to the basket, make a decision, and he does it so, so well.
Let's go on the court to Chris May.
Thank you very much. I'm here with Victoria's coach, Kyle Kos. Coach, first of all, congratulations. The state championship for you as a head coach, and I know you've got a special group of guys that did it with you.
I couldn't ask for anything else in my first year as a head coach. It just starts at the top of our school chain with our administration. I've got a great administration to work for. What a great day for Park Tudor School and the Park Tudor brand. I mean, hopefully we made the city proud today, made the school proud. But for these guys to give me everything they had for the Park Tudor team today, it showed on our effort today on the floor.
I know you've got so many players to be proud of. Earlier in the week, you called Trevon Bluiett a complete player, a total leader for your program. How about his performance today?
Well, I mean, it just shows. I mean, that's what he did. I think he had 38 and 11. When you look at his body of work over his career, 3 state championships, 2 Marion County championships, I don't know what else a kid could do to win Mr. Basketball. I hope the state was watching today. And you know, the thing about him is he doesn't care about the individual accolades, although it would be nice for him to be. He's a very deserving candidate.
Congratulations once again.
Thanks, Chris.
Appreciate it.
Time now for our presentation of the Arthur L. Trester Mental Attitude Award. It's proudly presented by the Indiana Pacers and Indiana Fever, who are honored to support Indiana's game at all levels.
And
Scott Gregg, the PA announcer, takes over from here as we have our award presentation.
The presentation of the 2014 Arthur L. Trester Mental Attitude Award, presented by the Indiana Pacers and the Indiana Fever. Making the presentation on behalf of the Indiana High School Athletic Association, from the Executive Committee, Nathan Dean of Jimtown.
We would like to first welcome Greg Schenkel of Pacers Sports and Entertainment to assist with the presentation of the Arthur L. Trester Mental Attitude Award for Class 2A Boys Basketball. On behalf of the Indiana Pacers and Indiana Fever, presenting sponsors of the Boys Basketball State Tournament, the IHSAA Executive Committee will award a $1,000 scholarship to the winner's school. Please join us in thanking the Indiana Pacers and the Indiana Fever for their generous support of our student athletes and high school basketball in the state of Indiana. After we announce the name of the recipient, we invite his parents to join him on the arena floor. The recipient of this award was selected by the IHSAA Executive Committee. The student was nominated by his principal and coach and excelled in mental attitude, athletic ability, scholarship, and leadership. The winner of the 2014 Arthur L. Trester Mental Attitude Award for Class 2A Boys Basketball is Jamar Weaver of Westview High School.
Congratulations to Jamar Weaver. He ranks 17th in his senior class. He's a member of the National Honor Society, the Spanish Club. He's going to do a mission trip this summer as well. He's going to play baseball this spring at Westview. Now, as you mentioned earlier, we'll play baseball at Huntington University next fall. You see mom and dad getting ready to join him on stage, Mervin and Juanita Weaver. They are from Shipshawana. Jamar is going to study business and management at Huntington University. Greg Schenkel of the Indiana Pacers is providing him with the trophy. Momentarily, Chris May will have the conversation with this young man. The Pacers and Fever, presenting sponsors of the IHSAA Boys Basketball State Tournament, are presenting a $1,000 scholarship to Westview High School in the honor of Jamar Weaver. And since 1989, more than $800,000 in college scholarships have been presented to deserving high school athletes in the state of Indiana. Courtside, we go to Chris May.
Thank you very much, Jamar. Congratulations, a special award. I know a special day for you, not the result you expected, but tell us how this day and this season has gone for you.
It was amazing. We started out, we didn't know what to expect, but we got here, and it's been awesome.
As you look back now and encapsulate your career, playing in front of fans like this, what has that meant to a young man?
It's awesome. These fans travel everywhere. Look at this. You don't see this everywhere, especially from a two-way school. You don't see it from a bigger school. It's awesome.
Mother Juanita, you must be very proud as well. What are your emotions?
I'm very proud of him. Praise the Lord.
Again, congratulations. Jamar Weaver is your Mental Attitude Award winner for Class 2A boys basketball.
We'll quickly step aside when we come back. The presentation of the runner-up medals and trophy to the Westview Warriors, followed by the championship trophy to Park Tudor. Back in just a moment.
Manager Jay Miller. Manager Josiah Miller.
The Sharp Business System Awards Celebration. The young men from Westview getting their runner-up medals, and soon the trophy presentation will follow. Mike Broughton, who will be a part of the 3A and 4A broadcast team here on Fox Sports Indiana, part of the IHSAA Executive Board. Of course, he won a state championship back in 1993 as the head coach at Jeffersonville. He is the gentleman putting the medals on these young men, capping off what was a phenomenal season. Westview finishes, Bob, at 23-5.
Yeah, you know what, and you talk about the two-way discussion of basketball teams at the beginning of the year, and you know, they knew they had a good basketball team. They come in unranked. They beat two ranked teams to get here, Greg, and just ran into a team, as we mentioned, has dominated this tournament in four of the past 5 years. But to do what they did, the accomplishment these kids have made to get here and play on this stage cannot be underscored, and how difficult it is and how proud they should be, and I know they are, of this opportunity to play for the championship.
And there you see the champ, or the runner-up trophy being presented. We're a very proud group of Westview Warriors. We'll see Park Tudor ceremony in just a matter of moments here on Fox Sports Indiana.
Presenting first to Colby Webster. Roland Stewart. And Lee Foster. Brandon Peterson. Jared Jackson. Nick Beeson. Trevon Bluiett.
Our Sharp Business Systems Awards celebration continues. These young men at Park Tudor, a lot of the reserves in this team are freshmen, so kids that are going through this experience for the first time. But for some of these seniors, this is quite the collection of these they have developed over the last 4 years.
Well, again, they have been the gold standard of 2A. And you know, great matchups with Bowman Academy. Bowman Academy obviously playing at 6 o'clock for the 3A championship, but you're looking at a team that has done something when you look in the annals of high school basketball, very few teams have been able to do, and that's win multiple championships in a short amount of time. And Trevon Bluiett to be congratulated, and as his teammates, because they've all done this collectively at both ends of the floor.
For a young man like Austin Shelton, it is his first state championship medal at Park Tudor. Let's quickly go to Chris May, who's standing by with Westview head coach Rob Yoder.
Thank you very much, Greg. Coach, I know, talking to you earlier this week, you started this season, the first game of your season, you said you had 5 regular varsity players due to injuries and illness. Seems like this team has come a long, long way, and you've got a lot to be proud of.
We have. We've improved constantly over the course of the season. By February, we were pretty good. Ran into a really good team that played really good today. They shot the ball extremely well, and some of them we maybe couldn't have defended them any better than we did. So Park Tudor deserves a lot of credit. They played extremely well. We're proud of our kids for getting here and for competing hard.
And I know this will mean a lot for you, your players, and the massive amount of fans you brought down.
Yeah, we're still playing. It's almost April, so our fans appreciate that, and we're happy for our kids. It's good for our community. And wish we could have won, but you can't. Not every team wins, so we're happy to be here.
Thanks for your time. Congratulations again.
Thank you.
Once again, Park Tudor, your 2A champions. We'll come back with more postgame coverage right after this.
That picture and that trophy added to the expansive case at Park Tudor School as they claim their third 2A state championship in the last 4 years. A key part of that picture, of course, Trevon Bluiett. He was a key aspect of many parts of the game for Park Tudor today. 38 points, 12 rebounds, and this slam, our Farmers Insurance highlight of the game.
Well, and one of many, but that underscores, I think, just how electrifying he truly is as a player. We saw him knock down a great number of opportunities from three, but clearly one of the state's best players.
Westview got it back within 5 early in the third quarter. A 13-0 run put this game away. Park Tudor, the winner of the 2A state championship, presented in part by the Indiana Pacers and Indiana Fever.
It was a record-setting performance for the Park Tudor Panthers as well as Trevon Bluiett. First of all, congratulations, a great effort. I know this is how you wanted to end your high school career.
Yeah, definitely. You know, there's no better feeling than going out on top. So, you know, I definitely feel great right now.
To have been here 3 out of the 4 years in your high school career, what has that meant to you? Have you had time to let that sink in?
You know, not yet, but, you know, eventually I know it'll mean a lot. You know, not too many high school players can be state champions for 3 years out of their four years in high school. So, you know, it's definitely special for me to be one of those people.
Talk just briefly about the game today. 38 points, 11 rebounds. You played awfully, awfully well.
You know, we just want to come out and push the pace. You know, they're a great team that like to play with us and they like to play our type of pace. So, you know, we just want to play our regular ball game. And, you know, fortunately for me, you know, shots were there. My teammates were, you know, on target with their shots as well. And, you know, it was just a good game overall.
Congratulations once again. He's a state champion again, Trevon Bluiett, the senior from Park Tudor. Today's winner of the 2A IHSAA Boys Basketball State Championship. It was a record-setting performance for the Park Tudor. It was a record-setting performance for the Park Tudor Panthers as well as Trevon Bluiett. First of all, congratulations, a great effort. I know this is how you wanted to end your high school career.
Yeah, definitely. You know, there's no better feeling than going out on top. So, you know, I definitely feel great right now.
To have been here 3 out of the 4 years in your high school career, what has that meant to you? Have you had time to let that sink in?
You know, not yet, but, you know, eventually I know it'll mean a lot. You know, not too many high school players can be state champions for 3 years out of their four years in high school. So, you know, it's definitely special for me to be one of those people.
Talk just briefly about the game today. 38 points, 11 rebounds. You played awfully, awfully well.
You know, we just want to come out and push the pace. You know, they're a great team that like to play with us and they like to play our type of pace. So, you know, we just want to play our regular ball game. And, you know, fortunately for me, you know, shots were there. My teammates were, you know, on target with their shots as well. And, you know, it was just a good game overall.
Congratulations once again. He's a state champion again, Trevon Bluiett, the senior from Park Tudor. Today's winner of the 2A IHSAA Boys Basketball State Championship.
Eight, seven, what is it? Midnight.
Yeah, we'll be on tomorrow. Now, hey, congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah, he's tired.
Other way around.
He's tired.
See you tonight.
See you, Chris.
104th Annual IHSAA Boys Basketball State Finals are brought to you by the Indiana Pacers and Indiana Fever, presenting sponsor of the IHSAA State Basketball Tournament, an honor to support Indiana's game at all levels. And by the following: Methodist Sports Medicine, in collaboration with IU Health, official sports medicine provider to the IHSAA. By Subway, eat fresh. Wilson Sporting Goods, the official ball of the IHSAA. Farmers Insurance, we are insurance, we are farmers. The Indianapolis Colts, the IHSAA, is proud to be Colt Strong. Sharp Business System, saluting great athletes and even better students. Sport Graphics, turning our creativity and experience into your results. And by Fox Sports Indiana, home of the IHSAA Champions Network. Final look at this one. Park Tudor, a winner, 84-57, and the stat line indicative of a 27-point margin in favor of the Panthers.
Well, shot the ball well, obviously, overall and specifically from three. 14-26, didn't need to get to the free throw line much, but all in all, when you shoot it like that and you get out and space the court and knock down shots, you're going to win a state championship, and it was an impressive display by Park Tudor.
Two state champions now crowned, Marquette Catholic in 1A, Park Tudor in 2A. And we've got two more games tonight for you in 3A and 4A. Should be phenomenal games. At 6 o'clock this evening, it will be Greensburg and Bowman Academy. At 8:15, it is Lake Central and Arsenal Tech. This 2A game, though, the property of Park Tudor. Trevon Bluiett's final game of his outstanding high school career, 38 points and 12 rebounds. Your final score, 84-57, Park Tudor the winner. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you at 6 o'clock for more high school state finals on Fox Sports Indiana.